Alright, what's up everyone? So, I am actually here live after finishing my Yooka-Laylee stream. I just finished the game early, and I've got about half an hour to 45 minutes to basically shoot the shit with stream chat. And I said, what the hell, impromptu Q&A video, where I'll talk to people in the stream chat and answer their questions. My hair's all screwed up because I'm wearing headphones. I don't care. I'm not going to go do my hair for this video or whatever. So let's see what people say. Let's see what people have to say here on the stream. Let's see what kind of questions they've got. Popsicolo says, if I facepalm, he can turn it into an emote for when we hit 250 subs again. Facepalm like this? Or like this? Or like this? How about that? That's a good one. There, I facepalmed. Clusta Angel asks, any plans on playing Danganronpa 2 in the future before Part 3 comes out? Well, here's the thing. I gotta finish part one first, which I am gonna be going back to shortly. I am gonna be playing it again to finish it up. Do I want to play part two? Sure. I mean, part one is great, right? But we already know now from part one that the game is quite long, like 30 to 40 hours long, and it's a ton of reading. It's not a playthrough that I could do on stream because it will end up getting spoiled. So in that regard, I wouldn't want to do it on stream. Oh, by the way, thanks to Howl in the Deep, who did a 600-bit cheer, and he says, thanks for finishing Yooka-Laylee. It was really fun to watch. Well, thank you, Howl, for the cheer, and thank you for watching. I'm glad that you enjoyed it. So, I want to play Danganronpa 2. However, number one, I still have to finish part one, and honestly, I don't think that playing the games back-to-back is a good idea, because that what will happen is that will create burnout, where it's too much of the same thing back-to-back, right? Now, Danganronpa 3 is supposed to come out at the end of September. However, I've already spoken to Spike Chunsoft, and they said, no, you will not be able to do a Let's Play. At the most, they'll maybe let you do, like, let you play the first chapter of it. So maybe, like, the first couple hours, all right? But then after that, they're not going to let you continue to do a Let's Play of it because it's a narrative-based game. And if the whole story gets leaked onto YouTube within a week of the game being out, basically, no one's going to buy the game, or at least that's what Spike Chunsoft feels. Now, I agree and I disagree. I agree because it is, unlike most other games I play, the Danganronpa series is very much all about the story. There's almost no gameplay in it at all. It's mostly just the story. So I can see if the story leaks right away, yeah, they might have an issue here where people won't buy the game. But I also disagree because take a look at what happened with Danganronpa 1 and 2. I played Danganronpa 1, and as I was playing it, tons of people told me, I never heard of this game before, it looks great, and they ran out and bought it. So I kind of disagree too, but I see their point. But the thing is, I won't be able to do a Let's Play of Danganronpa 3. Therefore, since I can't play Danganronpa 3, there's no rush to get to 2. You know what I mean? Like, let me finish Danganronpa 1 first. Let's see what happens, right? Let's see if come the summer, if there's downtime and I want to play Danganronpa 2. If not, save it. Save Danganronpa 2 for when there's downtime in the future, right? And then, maybe if I wait a while, a few months to a year or whatever, maybe they won't care about a playthrough of Danganronpa 3. Just sucks I can't do it as a new release, but there's not much I can do about it. Okay? Woobag asks, if I had to choose, which game has worse netcode, vanilla Mortal Kombat 10 or Street Fighter 5? Street Fighter 5 had worse at launch. Street Fighter 5's improved over time. Kind of the same thing with Mortal Kombat 10. The original netcode of Mortal Kombat 10 was terrible, but then after like a year, they patched it and it worked well. So, honestly, both of them sucked. Coral Guy says, Phil, I can't wait you to play Prey. I love the Dead Space franchise, and I'm wondering how similar it might be. And are you a fan of sci-fi horror, and what's your favorite? Honestly, outside of Dead Space, I don't think I've played another sci-fi horror game besides what was the Alien game that I played a couple years back? That was very much survival horror. That's what the game was meant to be. So I don't even know. Is that what Prey is? It's supposed to be kind of like survival horror with sci-fi elements? If so, I'm looking forward to it. That's going to be a crazy few weeks. Outlast 2 and then Prey the next week. That's going to be nuts. Alien Isolation. That was the name of it. Thanks, Omega Joker. Yeah, that was it. And then, of course, yes, Popsicolo. And then Aliens Colonial Marines was a horror game just for all the other different reasons. Completely wrong ones. Yes. Tour With Me asks, what are my thoughts on the next Call of Duty being World War II? Sounds fun. All right. I have two things to say. Number one, I'm actually excited because, like I've told everyone, the past few years, the past 2 to 3 Call of Duties, the multiplayer has been absolutely terrible because it became all about double jumping, wall running, kill streak, summon a million fucking drones, transform into a dog and swap people. Garbage. That's not what Call of Duty was made to be. That's not what the franchise was supposed to be. And just because they evolved it for the kiddies doesn't mean that it's good. It just means that they've watered it down to shit. And anyone who's a serious, like, adult who plays games would not want to fucking play that shit. It sucks, okay? You saw how little I played Infinite Warfare's multiplayer. I played, like, twice, and I was done. I couldn't stand it anymore. So from a gameplay perspective, I'm excited that the next Call of Duty is going to be a throwback to World War II. But, that being said, isn't it funny that Battlefield realized that they needed to go backward, you know, to a previous time, to an older school game, in order to get people to play it again, and therefore Battlefield 1 came out last year and was very successful. Isn't it funny that all of a sudden Call of Duty decides to do the same thing right after Battlefield? And it's funny because, it's so dumb. I mean, do I think there's going to be a sales increase this year because they're going to World War II? I don't think so. I don't think so at all. I think that, honestly, yeah, they may actually have some people come back to the franchise because they changed it back to old school. But I think just in general, Call of Duty as a franchise is dying because it's too much oversaturation. Shout out to Level Power, who just resubscribed to the channel for the 5th time in a row. Thank you, Level Power. Appreciate that. Gilgamesh X Saber asks, am I excited for Tekken 7? I am and I'm not. Let me explain. I'm pumped for Tekken. There hasn't been a new Tekken game in how many years? I mean, the last one I played was Tekken Tag Tournament 2, right? That was a long fucking time ago, man. That was ridiculously long ago. Remember I was making jokes on Twitter about my Wang? I think that was, I want to say it was 2013. I could be wrong, but I think it was 2013. So you're talking 3 to 4 years since there's been a Tekken game. So I am very excited for that, and I do want to play another Tekken game. But why am I not so excited? Because the game has already been out in Japan for years. It was in Japanese arcades, and I believe the Japanese console game has been out. So anyone who actually really wanted to play Tekken 7 already has. Like, they either had an imported console, or they found a way to play it. So I know what's going to happen. It's not going to be an equal playing field when this game comes out. It's going to be, you're going to have probably a couple hundred to a couple thousand people who already know everything about the game whatsoever. Everything, right? And they're going to master everything. So day one, you go online and you're going to play it with people just like you who don't know anything. Okay, and then all of a sudden this guy whoops your ass completely with insane combos and juggles and shit because he's been playing the game for years and probably watched every combo video of the Japanese players playing it. That's what I don't like about lead time between games coming out in Japan and the United States. And the problem was this used to always happen with fighting games, especially games like in the arcades. The Japanese would get these so much earlier than Americans. And then the Japanese would come to like Evo and win. It's like, well, no shit. You've been playing the game a year. We've been playing it for a month. Of course you're going to be better than us. It's not an equal playing field. And it's dumb in that regard. And I know, especially the hardcore fighting game community heads probably already had this game for like 2 years and have played the fuck out of it. And they're just going to be dominating everyone. So I hate that. I do. I think that's annoying. But there's not much I can do about it. And I do like Tekken, so I will be playing it. Zeranarth is asking, any interest in the Final Fantasy XII HD remaster? Now that Persona is on hold for Lord knows how long, it might be worth considering. Well, first of all, I didn't know that was coming out. I knew that, I heard that it was happening, but I didn't know when it was coming out. I guess it's coming out soon, from what you're saying. There's no chance I'm playing that now, dude. Just let me give you some perspective. This week, Outlast 2, The Walking Dead Season 3 Episode 4, and later this week, Little Nightmares, if I get to it, depends on how long Outlast 2 is. Plus, I got a ton of reviews and things to do. I got vlogging to do. I got a lot to do this week. Next week, I've got my Worst Games Ever Marathon, the Neo DLC, Prey, okay? A week after that, we've got Injustice 2. That's going to take up a ridiculous amount of my time, okay? Then after that, we've got Star Trek VR. Then in June, we've got Tekken 7. E3, of course, to cover. So it all depends. It all depends on what's going on with everything. There's also going to be a new Patron's Choice playthrough, as long as I hit the funding this month, which it looks like I'm going to on my Patreon. So, am I interested in playing Final Fantasy 12? Sure, a remaster of it? Okay, but I doubt it's going to happen anytime soon. Just being real here. Plus, Persona 5's on hold. If anything, I'm going to go back to Persona 5 during the summer before I start another RPG. Stormforce Gamer says, how am I going to do my E3 coverage this year? Probably the same as I always do. I'll be watching the conferences live if I can and reacting with you guys in the stream chat. But then I'll take notes and then I'll make the videos about them. Because, I mean, yeah, stream your live reaction. You may not realize this, but when I watch stuff, I don't go, wow, oh, ah, ow, oh. I don't do that because I'm not a fucking Muppet. Like all these idiots who do it on YouTube and on stream on Twitch, that's not me. I'm a human and I don't overact when I fucking watch stuff. So probably this would be me watching E3 coverage. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's coming out then. That's awesome. Okay. That's me. I'm a real human. I'm not an asshole overacting like a fucking Muppet to make views and whatever. So, I don't think anyone would even care about live reactions. If you watch them, you would hate my live reactions. I would rather take all the information down and then make a video that's edited that will have content in it that's informative to you and it covers all the points and it's not me going, ow, ooh, ah, like a fucking idiot. And that's the truth of it. Yeah, I know if I did live reactions, people would probably come on and cheer and send me tips or whatever. And honestly, it's not that big of a deal. You know what I mean? Like, to get the extra for the day or two that I'll be doing E3 coverage, it's not that huge of a deal. I do not agree with live reactions. I think they're dumb as fuck, and they're fake as fuck. 95% of them are garbage. They're people acting for dumb, ignorant people to watch and say, oh, it's so funny the way that they reacted to that, when it's not even real. Of course I'm looking forward to Red Dead Redemption 2. Celtics456 asked that question. Of course I am. Are you kidding me? I'm loving it. I can't wait. I loved Red Dead Redemption 1. We haven't had a full-fledged Rockstar game in years, right? The last Rockstar game was Grand Theft Auto 5. So it's going to be awesome to get that. I got an insulting tip that I'm not going to read. See, that's the thing. People think that if they tip me or they do something like a cheer or whatever, if they say do an insulting one, that I'm going to fucking still read it. No. Fuck you. Guys just blatantly just did it to insult me for a dollar. Yes. No, you don't get to insult me for a dollar, idiot. Chachamaru asked, what was my SAT score when I applied for college? I can't remember. I mean, that was so long ago. It was high. Actually, it was funny because I was the second highest in my school. When we tested for the SATs, for those who don't know, because people might not know what this even is, the SAT is a placement exam that high school students in the United States take, and based off of how you perform, it could actually allow you to get into better colleges or universities, okay? Covorus did a 10-bit cheer. He says, when are you going to dye your hair for the kiddies and act like a legit YouTube gamer? When do you think I'll dye my hair, folks? Anyway, I think you know I'm not like that. So the SAT placement exam, everyone gets to take it at least once, if not twice, while you're in high school. I took it twice, and I ended up being the second highest in my high school. The highest scoring person was actually this kid who was like this underachiever. This kid basically was apparently hyper smart, but no one knew it because his grades in school were like C's. And everyone, after he scored like insane, I think he had almost like a perfect score. And the teachers even like took him in, like the guidance counselor and his parents had a conference. And they're like, kid, why the hell did you score? You know, why do you not apply yourself to your schoolwork if you're this smart? And he's basically like, I don't give a fuck. Which is pretty funny. But I was the second highest, but for the life of me, I could not remember what my score was. I don't even remember what the scoring range is. Isn't it like based? Is the top score you could get on the SAT 1600 or 1800? I don't even know what the scoring system is. So I couldn't even answer that. Be the Boom says, am I going to play Middle Earth Shadow of Mordor? Am I going to play Middle Earth Shadow of War? And what are my thoughts on the Hobbit and Lord of the Rings franchise? Of course. Why wouldn't I play that? Like, obviously, I liked the first game. I definitely want to play the sequel. Why wouldn't I? And I actually like those movie franchises. I do like the original trilogy better than the Hobbit trilogy. The Hobbit trilogy really was kind of overdoing it. Because for those who don't know, the Lord of the Rings movies, the first three movies are based on three books. The Hobbit movie trilogy is based on one book. And it has just tons of filler crap that wasn't in the original books. And some of it's good and some of it, in my opinion, was not so good. So I definitely like the original trilogy way better than the Hobbit trilogy. But I like them both. I thought they were both good. King Gokin asks, am I going to buy another Nintendo Switch? Well, first of all, the question really should be, when could I even buy a Nintendo Switch? Because they don't exist. That no one around here has them in stock. At all. Apparently, you know, just like you would expect, when they get in stock, they sell out within a couple hours because of the idiots who think that there's some reason to own this system when in reality, there's not. There was Zelda. There's this Street Fighter game that's fucking just basically Street Fighter 2 HD Remix again with two new characters coming out. Oh my god, excuse me. After that, there's nothing until... I mean, Mario Kart? I don't care about Mario Kart. I already played on Wii U. It's the same fucking game. I think the next actual game that I would want to play on that console is in late July, Splatoon 2. I would like to maybe try. Will any stores have it by late July? I guess we'll find out. And go from there. But right now, there's no reason. Why on earth would I buy another Switch? It's just going to sit here and collect dust. So there's no reason for me to buy one. What the hell? Midnight Strike Force says, Phil, life or hometown? Which one? I don't even know what you're referring to. Life or hometown? You stumped me. I don't even know what that means. Jackson Hero has been asking all day if I'm going to get my Switch fixed. He must not be aware that I returned it. Because when I had it, there was none in stock and they had no idea when they were going to get more. And I wanted to play Zelda right away. I didn't want to wait. And going through Nintendo's support system, what would I going to wait 2 months to get the fucking thing back? In which case, what do I want it for? Because I want to play Zelda on it. So I returned it. I returned the broken one. All right. I switched it out, yes. Will I be playing any Mafia 3 story DLCs? No. Mafia 3 is done. That game was not good. The game was not very good. Because of the choices they made with that game, it was not one of my favorite games of the year, really. It was one of the most disappointing games of the year, and I have no desire to go back to it. So the answer is no, I will not be playing any Mafia DLCs. When is Poorly Cooking with the King coming back? Probably never. I told you all many times that I did all the recipes that I knew in that series. I did it to death. And I ended it logically when there was no other things to put out for it. And I am working when Leanna cooks. The other thing, people are like, well, why don't you do it with Leanna and have her do her real recipes and film that and release a new series, like Cooking with the Queen? Because I'm not down there. I'm working right now. She'll be working right now. Pretty soon she'll be working on dinner. I'll be right here. Working, so I'm not there to film it, and I can't not work to go film dinner. Let's see. Am I hyped? Doom Knight says, am I hyped about Dynasty Warriors 9? They announced it as an open world game. I don't know, man. Like, the Dynasty Warriors franchise has been done for a while. You know, you notice there hasn't been a game in many years. Because it's just the same thing over and over. They really didn't... Even the last two games were almost identical. They didn't really add any innovations or anything to them. Unless there's, like, something drastically changed about Dynasty Warriors 9, I don't know if I'll play it. Because it's just going to get boring after a little bit. It really is a grind game. That's, like, the purpose of the game. AD3030 says, will I play Fallout 1 and 2 or Fear 1 since I did 2 and 3? I mean, it's possible, but that would be a retro throwback series. That would have to be something people would want, you know? That's when I say, when I do events, like right now, my patron goal for this month is the Patron's Choice playthrough. That's the kind of thing you can do with that, is nominate and vote on a game that you want to see. Like, you want to see Fear 1, then you got to pledge and get in on that event. That's kind of the point of the Patron's Choice playthroughs. But no, I wouldn't just drop everything current that I'm doing to play an old game like that. Will I be playing Prey Opening Hour on the 27th? It's the first hour of the game demo. No, because I'm playing the actual game. So why would I play the demo on the 27th if it's going to be the first hour and I'm just going to play it again the week later? No, I'm not doing that. Yachirty says, Ferris Bueller or Breakfast Club? Ferris Bueller is a much better movie. Breakfast Club's okay, but I think Ferris Bueller is a great movie. Very funny. Ugh. I don't know why I'm yawning all of a sudden. I was actually fine playing the game, and all of a sudden, I'm yawning like crazy. Weird. Fluttershy1970 says, Phil, will you bring back the Hate Live, and will you stream it on Twitch, and will you talk about wrestling on it? Well, here's the thing. When I used to do Hate Live, all right, I did it as a once-a-month thing, pretty much. Sometimes it was every 2 weeks, but usually it was once a month. And it was this big show that covered all these topics, right? It was a show that covered current events, back-in-the-day segment, gaming news. I would talk about wrestling sometimes. I would talk about everything. And it's like one-stop shop if you want to hear my opinions on everything. And the show did well. In general, you know, that show always did between 5,000 to 10,000 views, if not more. It all depended on what I talked about in the show in particular, all right? And I did enjoy doing Hate Live. I did. I actually liked that. So, I liked that. But, here's the thing. Last year, I changed up my formula, and I said, oh, the way I'm going to do this is, I'm going to do focused vlogging on the King of Hate vlogs, I'm going to do edited videos on KO Gaming, and I'm going to do raw gameplay on DSP Gaming. As we know, that worked out, and then guess what happened? YouTube ad revenue plummeted. YouTube no longer, you know, makes much money at all on anything. And honestly, my DSP Gaming, my King of Hate Vlogs channel makes no money. I can tell you right now what I made, because this, I'm not in a contract with anyone on the King of Hate Vlogs. When Ask the King came out, guess how much money I made the day that Ask the King came out? $7. $7. On average, I probably make $3 to $5 a day over on the King of Hate Vlogs. I have little to no motivation whatsoever to release vlogs because YouTube's ad revenue has plummeted so badly, there's no way to make money on them. Now, DSP Gaming, I've got 43,000 gameplay videos, right? I put out a ton of videos a day. The videos get thousands of views. They accumulate. I end up making okay money on DSP Gaming. But on the vlogging channel, I make nothing. It's like pittance. So there's no way I'm going to try to do an increased focus on vlogging or anything like that. Now, here's a good, here's something that I like that someone said. They said, why don't you live stream Hate Live? Good idea. Because if I live streamed Hate Live, people may be cheering, people might sub, people might actually leave tips during the stream, right? And that would allow me to actually have interaction with the stream. I could talk with people during the show, right? It would be a little bit different of how the show used to be. It would be more interactive, I think. But maybe that could work. So who knows? Maybe Hate Live will come back. Maybe it will. That might make sense because it made sense last year to split up vlogs and put them out as separate vlogs on the King of Hate Vlogs channel. Now it doesn't anymore because that channel makes no revenue. So if I could make the Hate Live podcasts profitable here on stream, then I would consider bringing them back. Okay. So we'll see. Let's see what people say. Let's see, you know, if you like it, you like what I'm doing, if you want to see Hate Live return and be a show where I talk all about wrestling and gaming news and YouTube issues and my personal life and all kinds of stuff, it may return. I may do it. Maybe I'll do it like once every month or something like that. Okay, we'll see. But let me know if you want to see it. You got to let me know if you want to see Hate Live return, all right? Five 8 2 0 1, I think was his name, said, "Yo, I think Red Dead Redemption 2 will be a sequel or a prequel." Well, let me put it this way. I hope it's a sequel. That game ended perfectly to have a sequel where John Marston's son would take up the reins as the protagonist of the next game. But it might be a prequel, in which case I'm not going to be as excited about it, but I still hope that it's a good game. A lot of people are saying they loved Hate Live and they wish I would bring it back, so maybe I will. Maybe I will, if this is what people want. Viking just did a 100-bit cheer. He said, "Hate Live hype." And now Howl in the Deep did a 100-bit cheer. He said, "Hate Live hype." StarCraft Remastered, Orcs Dork 7. Nice name. Asked, "Will I ever play StarCraft Remastered?" You know, there's certain game genres that I've tried, all right? I've played pretty much every kind. One of the ones that really just never worked out was RTS. The very few RTS games over the years that I've played really didn't catch anyone's interest. StarCraft, I love the series, and I played StarCraft 2 when it was new, and no one really cared. I don't think I'll be playing RTS games. Just say, they just don't seem to pique anyone's interest. Nolver87 with a 13-bit cheer. He says, "Fuck it, we'll do it. Hate Live." Howl in the Deep says, "What is the next sports game that I'll be playing?" You know, I don't know. I was going to play MLB, but then it turned out that a bunch of other stuff happened. Like, for example, I was going to do MLB at the end of March, and then the Dark Souls 3 DLC got announced for that same week. And I was like, well, that's it for MLB for that week, right? And that's kind of seems what's been happening. I mean, MLB, the thing is, it's a sports game. It's not a game that I had to play when it was new. Maybe during the summer downtime, I'll play MLB. But honestly, that's really the only game I'm interested in right now. Like, I really don't feel like playing NBA or Madden or anything like that. And I've tried NHL and people didn't really like it. So maybe I'll play MLB during the summer downtime, because that would be cool, right? That's a game that has cool chat interaction. You get a hit and everyone goes, yeah, and they cheer or they go crazy in the stream chat. And then you whiff, oh, and everyone does an emote, a failure emote or something, right? Clesta Angel says, to confirm, I'm not going to be playing Fire Emblem in May because of Nintendo claims. First of all, I probably wouldn't play Fire Emblem to begin with. It's an RPG. Right now, I'm already in the middle of Danganronpa, and I got Persona 5 on hold. I don't think I would want to start another RPG right now. But if it is a Nintendo title, chances are, yeah, we'd get claims too. So it's kind of a double whammy why I'm not playing Fire Emblem. Be the Baby asks, will I play Valkyria Chronicles during the summer downtime? It's a perfect, since it's a long strategy third-person shooter hybrid game. Right now, my plans for the summer are very simple. I'm going to either do a Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin run or a Bloodborne The Old Hunters DLC Redemption run. One or the other. I also maybe will be replaying a Grand Theft Auto game, since all of my Grand Theft Auto playthroughs are now destroyed on YouTube. All the music is either muted, the videos are blocked, it's terrible. The playthroughs have been demolished. So I kind of want to do one of those. And then, of course, I'm going to balance that with whatever the patrons choose for that patron's choice playthrough. That is for this month's goal. So that's going to probably start in June and continue through July. And I don't know what game they'll choose, so we'll see what game that is. So I guess we'll see. Those are my plans for the summer. No, I have no plans to play an incredibly long RPG during the summer. If I do play one, it'll be Persona 5. I'll try to return to Persona 5. But no, I have no plans on these incredibly long JRPGs. (Clears Right. It would be a Dark Souls 2 no Lightning Spear redemption run. I'd play Dark Souls 2 again as if the Lightning Spear didn't exist. I'd do a totally different build, probably a melee combat build with shield or whatever like I did in Dark Souls 3. That's probably what I would do. Alucard asks, have I ever played a MOBA game? Yes, but not for YouTube. I actually played Dota. Back when it was new, I played that. When Warcraft 3 first got that mod to do that stuff, I played it. And I've played a couple over the years, but there's no way I'm getting into a MOBA. There's just no way. It's too time-consuming. The community is already too inclusive and elitist. There's no reason for me to ever play it. Phoenix Wright Trials of Tribulations is out. I'm not doing that anytime soon because I'm already doing Danganronpa. That's the same kind of game. No Phoenix Wright anytime soon. Rogue Pixie is asking, will I ever play Styx or Shard of Darkness since I like stealth games? I've never heard of them. No one's ever asked for them before until today. So probably not. There you go. No, don't even know what they are. They're not on my radar whatsoever. Any other questions? We're kind of winding down here now. How long has this video been? 31 minutes? Really? Apparently I've been talking for a half hour already. I didn't even realize that. Spectral A asks, who is the greatest wrestler of all time? Many people have asked this question. Who is the greatest professional wrestler of all time? Among all the years of data collected and all the opinions of the public, everyone has come to the consensus. The greatest pro wrestler of all time is, of course, the one and only, the one, Billy Gunn. There you go. Deserved says, I would love to see you play Ultimate Street Fighter 4 Final Round or whatever the hell it's called. I hope you can get a Switch to play. I'm not getting a Switch. I don't have the money. I don't have the $400 or whatever. $300 or $400? I don't even remember. I don't have that money to blow on a system to only play one game right now. I have no plans on playing any other games on that system besides Splatoon 2. So I'm not buying a Switch. There's none anyway. They don't exist. I can't buy it. And there's nothing to play on it anyway. So, no. Am I going to play Mario Odyssey when it comes out? Two factors involved there. Number one, will I have a Switch when Mario Odyssey comes out? Or will Nintendo continue to not manufacture enough to quell demand? That's the question. Number two, will I be able to put any videos on YouTube? Because if the bottom line is, if I'm still kind of, you know, where I am now, at the end of the year when Mario Odyssey comes out and I can't make any money, I doubt it. You know, Zelda was an exception because everyone was rating Zelda one of the highest games of all time and ended up being one of my Game of the Year picks so far. But I don't think I'm going to go crazy to go play Mario when I can't make any money on YouTube on it. Just saying. Movie Lord says, any chance I could do a retro playthrough of Psychonauts? I already played Psychonauts. I have a full playthrough up when it came out in HD on last generation of consoles. I played it. So that's already on my DSP gaming channel. You can find it right now. I should bring this up while I got some people here listening to me. If you ever want to know what games I've played in the past, go to thekingofhate.com. That's my website. Upper right-hand corner, there's a playlists button. Or if you're on mobile, there's a drop-down. It should say playlists. Click on that. A search box will pop up. Type in the game you want to look for. It will find it. It doesn't matter if I've played it on Darkside Field, DSP Gaming. It brings up all of my playthroughs. So use that search engine. It works perfectly for YouTube. And it cuts through all the bullshit where you can't find anything on YouTube. That works for all my game, all my playthroughs. So check that out. Popsicolo just linked it 3 times in the stream chat. There you go. The Savage Beast is asking me, will I do a Mass Effect 2 Renegade Fenshep run this year? Probably not. Andromeda killed any kind of hype there was for Mass Effect. The game was so fucking shitty compared to the other games in the series. I don't think anyone wants any more Mass Effect right now. I definitely want to do a Mass Effect 2 Fenshep second run in the future, but there's no way I'm doing it anytime soon because Andromeda completely destroyed that fucking franchise. Thank you, Movie Lord 101. Give me a shout out. He said, you're one of my favorite YouTubers. Thank you. Appreciate that. Am I going to play the Crash Insane Trilogy? Asks Jaybird. Sorry, I'm stretching my legs. Ugh! I want to play Crash 3 because I never played Crash 3 before. So I might get the trilogy and just play Crash 3 and then later in the future if anyone wants me to replay 1 or 2. But I just played 1 or 2 the past couple of years, so I don't think there's going to be demand for those. Do I use any product in my hair? Says Darkwing. No. I know my hair does not look stylish. It looks like shit. It's because I was wearing headphones. I screwed it all up. Oh my goodness. Spectral keeps asking, what's my favorite wrestling match of the last year? I don't know. There's been a lot of good ones. Now that they finally got, you know, all these guys from the indies coming into the company, there's been a ton of good matches. That's the problem. It's not like it used to be where the matches were all shit. And then at a rarity, there'd be a good one. You say, oh, match of the year contender. No, now it's like there's a lot of good matches all the time. The quality, the bar of wrestling has gone up, in my opinion. So I don't know. I couldn't even tell you because I don't, off the top of my head, I can't even remember half the matches from the last year. So I don't really have a pick. Alucart 177 says, Lost Odyssey is a great game. You should do a playthrough when there's downtime. I love Lost Odyssey. Lost Odyssey was one of the few games that I played during that time right before I went on YouTube. That year, when I started playing all the major releases, before I'd ever recorded a YouTube video, because I wanted to reimmerse myself in the realm of video games. And I loved Lost Odyssey, but I'll be honest, it's a long game, and it's tough, it requires grinding, but I would like to do a playthrough, but that's the thing, these long JRPGs, just take a look at Persona 5, for example, a white hot, new JRPG, just came out, everyone wanted to see me play it. Guess what? I stopped playing it at the 7-7 date that Atlas said to stop playing it at. The videos aren't even getting views anymore. Like, if you look, they're not even getting, like, 1,000 views per video. Some of them aren't even getting, like, 500. So, almost no one has followed along just the 40 hours I've done in that game. That's the problem with JRPGs. They don't retain interest. They just don't. They never do. Yeah, there's maybe a few hundred people who will watch the whole playthrough, but me playing a 200-hour RPG when I'm only going to get people to watch for like 4 hours at the beginning and everything else I'm wasting my time. You see what I mean? That's the problem. I would love to do a long JRPG. I want to play Suikoden. I want to play Final Fantasy IV. I would like to play Secret of Mana. I would like to play Lost Odyssey. There's a ton of games. Super Mario RPG. I would love to play any of those games, but they don't retain interest. People watch two parts and get bored because it's not modern graphics. It's not flashy enough. You know what I mean? All right, we're winding down, everyone. I'll take just a couple more questions because we're almost out of time here. I'll take a couple more questions and then I'll get to uploading, okay? Yanu1 says, if I was given the opportunity to continue working on YouTube but doing something other than gameplay, what would I do? I never would have stopped doing creative videos. Like, the problem is I'm a one-man crew. I don't have video editing expertise. I don't have filmmaking expertise. I don't have a budget. I don't have a crew. I have nothing, right? I would like to do creative series. I always wanted to do creative series. Remember when The Hateful Truth premiered, it had some creativity like mixed in with it. It wasn't so much a serious review series as much as a thing with comedy skits in it and just kind of, you know what I mean? But I just don't have the means to do it. You know, I'm not one of these people that comes into YouTube with money that somehow I already have, and I have a team of fucking people with me, and we make a business, and then we have a studio. It's never going to happen, you know? That's the thing. Everyone's like, oh, Phil, you're behind the times. Everyone else has high-quality footage. Yeah, and look at that. They came into YouTube with money, with a budget. You know, they came in with, like, with the attitude that this was going to be a job and all that. It's never for me. It was never that. It's just me having fun here every day, you know? You know, for as much as a shitty way that Project 7 ended, when we were making Project 7, it was a ton of fun. Yeah, it was a ton of work, but it was a ton of fun, and I think that it could have went somewhere. If I had finished that series and done a season of Project 7, it could have went somewhere. The problem was, you know, it didn't go anywhere. There was a falling out. The people who were working on the series with me did not clearly tell me what they were looking for. They lied to me, actually, which I'm not going to get into here. They lied to me about what they were looking for out of the project, and, you know, it fell apart, and since then, I never really bothered anymore. I was like, why am I going to bother with another creative series when I don't have the means to do it myself, and I can't depend on other people? And that's why I never really did one again. A lot of people say I should do politics and stuff. I should do a politics channel. As much as talking about politics and that kind of stuff, I think, would get interest, two things. Number one, politics are such a polarizing issue. I know for a fact there are people out there who watch my gameplay stuff right now. They're watching this stream probably. But if I just made a political statement right now that they didn't agree with, they'd be completely turned off and say, I never want to watch anything Phil ever does again. Because sadly, there are some people out there who think the world is black and white. They don't realize that there could be different opinions on certain things, and it's acceptable to not hate someone for one of their fucking opinions that you don't agree with. I mean, I really, you know, YouTubers in general have been getting in trouble about this stuff recently. They say one thing, and people are like, oh my god, I can't believe that YouTuber feels that way. And next thing you know, they get slammed or whatever, right? So, that's number one. Number two, tons of political channels on YouTube now no longer get ad revenue. If you haven't heard, there's a bunch of political channels where they're like focus on either left-wing or right-wing politics. They don't make money anymore. They have been flagged as advertiser unfriendly by YouTube, and therefore they can't even make a living anymore, and a lot of them are closing, or they're going to have to change their formula up somehow. So even if I even did politics on YouTube, I might not be able to even put ads on the videos. So that's definitely a no-go right now. All right, I think one more question, and we're going to wrap this up, folks, because it is hitting the time when I would finish my stream usually anyway, and this has been a 42-minute Q&A session, so... Honor Rub asks, do I think Persona 5 is the JRPG of the century? I mean, of the century? it's very good. I really like the game, okay? I really enjoy it. But, is it the best game ever? That's a subjective thing, I think. I mean, you could objectively say, this is good about the game. This is a good thing. This is an improvement over the previous games in the series. This is a bad thing. But can you say it's the best game ever? I don't know. I like it, and definitely it's a game of your contender for me. But I'm only a third into the game, too, so I can't really judge. But I definitely really like the game. All right, last question from MXTT. He says, I think it's like MXTT10389. He says, why don't I take my GSP gaming channel and change my videos from 10 to 15 minutes long to an hour long? Because I would go out of business overnight. Because, ladies and gentlemen, here's the deal. And this is the truth of the matter. After years of trying different things, here's the truth. Raw playthroughs, okay? It doesn't matter how long raw playthroughs are. Raw playthroughs, like I do for YouTube, are going to get skipped through. And what I mean by that is I don't make a highlights video for you of here's the best 40 minutes of gameplay from today's session of Yooka-Laylee. I do, here's today's Yooka-Laylee footage, and I just put it on the channel because I don't have time to sit here and edit through it and do the best of, because then I won't have time to play keep playing games and having fun and doing streams like this one with you. I wouldn't have time to do it, okay? So... if I did that, if I was putting out one-hour videos that were montages of the best moments, then it might work. But I don't do that. I put out raw gameplay. So here's what's happened, folks. When I first started on YouTube with raw gameplay, I put out 10-minute clips because back then, you couldn't upload a clip longer than 10 minutes. YouTube would not allow you to, all right? Over the years, people changed their formulas on YouTube and made their videos now 30 to 40 minute long edited videos for YouTube. And people watch the shit out of them, and there's high engagement on those videos because it's like the best of moments. That's what's popular on YouTube right now. Not raw playthroughs like I do. Now, there's a place for raw playthroughs. There's still a fan base for it because I still get a lot of views every day. I still get anywhere from, I think, 50,000 to 100,000 views a day on DSP Gaming. So there's still a market for it, okay? But it's not the mainstream market. So here's what's happened, all right? The past several years since I moved across the country, 2014 I moved, I said, I'm going to do what people are telling me. Everyone's telling me I need to make longer gameplay videos. And then if I make longer videos, it'll be better because people like longer videos and they'll come and watch fewer videos and they won't complain about their inboxes being spammed with videos, okay? All right. I did this from 2014 to early 2017. I gradually increased the length of my videos from 10 and 15 minutes all the way up to 30-minute videos. So earlier this year, all right, I was actually putting out videos that were around 25 to 30 minutes long. That was my average gameplay video. When I did a stream, I was only uploading like 6 videos per stream. Guess what happened? My views went boo, and my viewer engagement also went boo. Why? Why did that happen? Because the same people watched the videos. I wasn't getting any increased traffic. So the same people watched the videos. Almost no new viewers came to watch the videos, despite the fact that they were longer and everyone claimed it was going to help me. It didn't help me at all. I didn't get any additional new viewers for making longer videos. And my engagement tanked because when you watch a raw let's play of a game, you're going to fast forward through parts. There's going to be a part where, oh man, I got to go from this side of the dungeon to that side of the dungeon again to backtrack to get an item. Most people will just skip ahead. Right? Maybe you're watching an ongoing playthrough and you're really liking my Zelda playthrough, but you don't care about this one particular puzzle. You want to see what the next thing I do in the open world is. You skip ahead. And that kills engagement. Versus if I were only doing the best of moments, you're not going to skip ahead. You're going to watch that whole video from start to finish. So those longer videos that were edited montages, right? Those had high viewer engagement because no one was skipping through them. My videos, everyone's skipping through them. Now the problem is, here you go. I put out a 10-minute video. Out of the 10 minutes, 3 minutes are boring. So everyone skips ahead 3 minutes. Okay, so now YouTube's showing I have a 7-minute average engagement on my videos. If I'm putting out a 30-minute video, and people are like, this part's boring, they skip 5 minutes. Okay, watch another minute. That's boring, they skip another 5 minutes. Okay, this last 10 minutes is great. The engagement completely gets fucked up. YouTube basically thinks you're going to skip 30, 40, 50, 60% of every video that I put out there, and it actually kills my channel. It makes it so that my channel can't get the best ads, and that I don't show up in, like, search engines at all because of it. So, actually increasing the length of my raw gameplay videos from 2014 to 2017 hurt me rather than helped me, okay? It actually concretely hurt me. Now, since March, I made the change. I went back to the old style of short videos, 10 to 15 minutes long. Guess what happened? My viewer engagement is up tremendously. It went up a big chunk because now it's saying, oh, you're putting out a 10-minute video. Most people are watching, I don't know. I have no idea. This is off the top of my head. I don't know what the stat is. I don't know. 60 to 70, 80% of the video, all right? That means that my videos are now in better standing with YouTube. Versus the old style, I would put out a 30-minute video, YouTube would say, oh man, people fast-forwarded through 2/3 of your video, your video sucks. And it would be a low ranking and it would be low standing with YouTube. So because of the way YouTube works, and because I put out raw gameplay instead of the montage edited stuff, longer videos don't work for me, they actually hurt me. Now, it is true that when I changed that style back to the old style I used to do, the shorter videos, I lost a few hundred subscribers. People complained, oh, Phil's uploading too many videos a day and they unsubscribed, okay? Guess what happened to my views? They remained the same. So all that tells me is that it didn't hurt me at all. I didn't really lose anyone. People just unsubscribe because they don't like getting spammed in their inbox, but people are still watching the videos. And in fact, now the subscribers that left, I'm building them back up. I've noticed this month now, they're coming back. So it doesn't matter that I changed my video to shorter videos. There's been no negative effect that the videos are shorter, only positive. And therefore, I'm going to continue to do the 10 to 15 minute videos, at least for now, and see what happens. Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone. appreciate you being here, hanging out with me for the past 45 minutes or so. At this point, it's almost 50 minutes. I'm going to upload this video to YouTube. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope people find this video informative. And that's it. I'm going to upload, obviously, the conclusion to Yooka-Laylee. And that's it. So thanks, everyone.